As of last Tuesday, Adobe's made it easier to select objects in Photoshop. Let's look at this brand new feature. So the object selection tool is not new in Photoshop, but some of the features are. So we're going to go down and we're going to choose the object selection tool. And then we're going to turn the object finder on by default. It's going to find the objects. And that means as I roll over, notice this, we get the individual faces, different parts of the photograph. So to select any one of these, we just simply click and it will load the selection. Now the algorithm has also been improved to get a better selection. Notice that these edges are looking quite nice. Let's go in here. So when you see this outline, just remember this is not the actual selection. The selection is actually going to be nicer than that. We have some options up here. If we turn on this view all, it will show all the objects within. Now, if we want to select individually, what we can do is just click and drag. Say, for example, we want to grab her shirt. Let's just click and drag the rectangle over there. Notice it makes a selection around her clothing. Now, when we go into select a mask, one of the things you'll notice here that we also have the object selection tool in here. So we could use the Alt Option key to hit the minus and we could remove certain things like the hair there. Let's do the same thing there. And look at that, does quite well. Now you don't have to use a rectangle. You can also use the lasso if you want to get more precise selection. So let's go around there, take that away from the selection. Nice. All right, so some of those features are new, some aren't. Let me show you something that is totally new. So let's grab our object selection tool and look at this. Now I can isolate sky, it can isolate foreground areas. And if I'm going to select the whole foreground, let's just click on that. And you can see it does a pretty decent job. So say I decide to mask this out, let's just click on the mask. Let's invert it, drag this underneath, and you know, it's not too bad. So one of the amazing new features is the composite selection. So here we are inside a composite, and a composite is an image that's made out of lots of different layers. So right now we're on this flower layer. So if we make any kind of selection on the layer, typically we can grab our object selection tool and if we roll over, the flower is going to be selected, but nothing else is. Even if I drag around, say, these birds, notice it says, hey, it's not going to work because there's only the flower on that layer. So we have an option to choose this little icon here, samples colors from composite image. So that means now I can select around these birds and it will make the selection from the birds. If I want just the flower, I can grab the flower. If I want the whole model, including the flower, I can just drag it around there and select it. Now, this is going to update in real time. You'll notice that when I change anything, this little icon is going to go. So say, for example, I hide the flower. Notice the little icon's going again, and now it's reselecting. If you don't want that to work automatically, what we can do is go under this option, turn off auto refresh, choose manual refresh. Now we can start working on our composite and it's not updating. See, there's a little icon that shows us, hey, it isn't updated. And you know, we can go through, we can add some different things, you know, get our composite exactly how we want it. And then when we're ready, then we can just click here and it will manually search. And then also the nice thing about that is these are not going to pop in and out while you're working. You can also turn these off just by hitting the object finder. And that way, as we're working, these areas are not being highlighted. Now you can also change the color of these highlights. Let's turn the object selection back on. And maybe pink is not the right color. So just choose the little gear here. And under the color here, we can change it to something, I don't know, like a yellow. And now when we roll over, we're going to get a different color. So I just wanted to touch on some of those new features in the object selection tool. Let me know in the comments underneath if you're going to find this useful in your work. So I'm going to create a new video soon where we're going to dig into even more new features I haven't shown you yet. So if you don't want to miss those, make sure you hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. I'll give you a link to my full review of Photoshop 2023 as well as Lightroom 2023. So anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this, smash that like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.